the NIH certainly has set a precedent for the rest of the world. Science was not just a responsibility to be left either to private industry or to the academic sector without support from the government.
Today, there are 1,600 clinical trials being conducted at Building 10. They encompass everything from neurological disorders to gene therapy to diseases so rare they impact only a very few patients.
All right, are you going to stop yourself or should I stop you?
I can stop myself.
Lucy Weiss has one of the rarest diseases in the world, Job syndrome. A genetic disorder that affects fewer than 300 people in the United States.
Your music is great.
Thank you.
When Lucy was first born, she was overall healthy, but she had a lot of what seemed to us at the time to be small, unrelated health issues. She had a lot of rashes, a lot of skin infections. She had a skull formation issue as well. And as she got a little bit older, we saw some gross motor delay. No one really knew what it was. It just didn't fit any normal mold.
I want to see how high I can climb.
You can try. Whoa, Lucy.
Ta-da! I'm taller than you, Mama.
Sure are.
When she was 3 years old, she was admitted to the hospital with esophageal thrush, which is very uncommon in patients her age who have a normally functioning immune system. They recognized Lucy's combination of symptoms for what they were, Job syndrome.
Hello, Lucy.
Hello, Mom.
Those born with Job's have an incomplete immune system, which can make some infections deadly.
Awesome, Lou. I love it.
By the time we got the diagnosis, it was almost a relief.
Yes.
Because it explained so much of what had been so confusing for the past 3 years.
There is no cure for Job's. But since Lucy's diagnosis, she has been observed and treated at Building 10, which is a leading facility in the world for the study of rare diseases and has a team devoted to Job syndrome.
Hold it. I'll get you down.
After several life-threatening infections, Lucy's doctors are now confronted with the task of trying to fix her dangerously incomplete immune system.
An immune system is largely the white blood cells that function to fight off the invaders that come in from the world, the bugs, the bacteria, the viruses. It should be able to recognize things that are foreign and attack those things and get rid of them.
When immune cells go hopelessly awry, they can lead to problems almost anywhere.
The trials at Building 10 have the potential to change the course of medical science. In Bo Cooper's case, that may mean a new way to fight a leukemia for which there currently is no cure.
Doing good, Bo.
Over the past 6 years, Bo has undergone several rounds of chemotherapy and a bone marrow transplant. Each time, his cancer has returned, more resilient and resistant to standard care.
Bo has rapidly progressive leukemia. It is always an aggressive cancer. Unless treated, it goes from small levels to, you know, lots of cancer in very short periods of time. The surprise was that he came in with a new fever.
I'm in pain. It's really bad right here.
Does it hurt when I rub on your leg?
Yep.
It's worse than it was before.
Leukemia is not fun. It's not fun for anyone. There's major bone aches. You can't even touch your skin, really.
Leukemia is a cancer that originates in the bone marrow, the interior of the bone that produces blood cells.
So what we're looking at here is Bo's bone marrow. What we see in this bone marrow is essentially wall-to-wall leukemic cells. His leukemia is dividing out of control. 90% of the space of his bone marrow is infiltrated with leukemia at this point. If this goes without treatment, he would likely not survive more than, weeks to a few months.